What's out there? What did this to him?
They're called Trodon Pectinodon. They were meant to be euthanized, but...
What? You let them out?
No. I kept them in quarantine for study. I thought they may have been leaving the pen somehow, but I wasn't certain.
You knew about those damn creatures all along. While we were out there, exposed, humping around like idiots looking for our pilot.
Billy, wait.
We were nearly killed by one of our own men. Probably bitten by one of those things, just like Decaf. Who knows where his catatonic body is now? Both our teams are dead. Oscar's dead. All because of your dinosaurs, all because of you.
Billy, listen, I get it. You're angry, but we need Laura alive. She's the only one here familiar with what we're dealing with.
And what good does it do us if she keeps that intel to herself? Anyway, this witch is a liar. She's lied to all of us, put me in the direct line of danger to protect her agenda and her precious freak show. What else is she hiding?
Please, if I knew sooner.
Ah, shut it. Speculated.
No. Speculating could have led us into even more danger.
So what? I'm the enemy? I'm the bad guy here? I'm just trying to open your eyes. I'm trying to show you the truth and bring someone to account for it.
Injun is the enemy here. They spoiled the island. They made these monsters. You can't make her pay for all that Injun has done.
Maybe.
Put down the knife. We need to work together, all of us.
She has to say, it's my fault. It's my fault. Come on, Doc, let me hear it.
No, it wasn't.
Say it!
It's my fault.
There. That wasn't so difficult, was it? Your friends may have saved you here. At least I got the truth out of you. You want her alive? You got it. Just mark my words. She will save just one of those animals before she lifts a finger to help you. Now, everyone make themselves useful. I've got to tend to you.
Look, we can't stay here long. Let's just give Billy a minute and see if we can find anything useful. A way out, even.
Okay. We'll do a sweep of the room and check in when we're done. Agreed?
Leave the door alone. We're not going back out that way.
Why not?
Because we aren't backtracking, and those damn creatures could still be out there.
I don't see anything. Maybe it's clear. They're empty. They're still heavy, though. Huele excremento. I hate being trapped on here like a rat.
I get stuck at a vent with a dinosaur. Besides, there's blood everywhere.
Ow! Hot!
A flare kit. This might come in handy.
Are you okay?
Jess, hon, leave him alone.
Great. It's locked. Anyone happen to have a key? What about this grate? It looks big enough for everyone.
And it looks like it's heading in the right direction.
This tunnel looks tall enough for everyone. Maybe we should go this way.
Jess, stand back from the grate. You don't know what's down there.
I'm just trying to help.
I know, Jess. I just can't keep my attention on everything at hand, plus you.
Sorry to be such a burden.
Billy, we should cover Decaf. I don't want Jess to see this.
Yeah.
I don't understand. I thought the dinosaurs couldn't breed.
They can't. They're all female.
Then how do they lay eggs?
Theropods shed eggs just like most other egg-laying animals. Think about chickens. The whole egg market is made up of unfertilized eggs, right?
Oh, yeah. So they still have to lay them?
Oh, my.
What is it?
You bring up a good point about our dinosaurs ovulating, but these eggs are gathered in a clutch. This is brooding behavior.
So, chickens will brood a large enough clutch?
But not our dinosaurs. I've found post-ovulatory eggs in the ranges. They're mal-shaped, usually destroyed or kicked into the bush.
I see. Wait, we can't jump to any conclusions. How could this even be possible?
Could a girl dino turn into a boy dino?
With Dr. Wu's slapdash approach to gene sequencing, anything could go wrong.
I pick this lock. Not that I would know how. I don't want to add breaking an entry onto my dad's list of my criminal tendencies. So if this whole trip was like set up to scare me away from shoplifting, mission accomplished.
Jerry, we should get moving.
Yeah, are you ready?
This is not the time for grieving. We have to move.
Maybe we should...
She's right.
Did you find something?
No, nothing. Is everyone ready?
What about Decaf?
I took care of that.
It looked like you took something off him. And if he has something that will help us...
I didn't find anything. I took his dog tags. Insurance doesn't pay out to his family unless his dog tags are returned. Satisfied?
Right. Sorry for pushing. Should we bring him with us?
Why bother? He's already buried. Look, I know where his body is. We're not equipped to transport it. Hopefully, we can retrieve his remains when this is all over. All right, listen up. Everything that just happened, bygones, understand? Doc, tell me again about the phones.
According to the terminal in my lab, the Marine exhibit phones are still connected to the transceiver. The visitor center phones
are... Too far away, okay? And we can get to the exhibit through the tunnels?
They're all interconnected. I think I can still find...
The answer is yes. Thank you. Alright, we all have the same priorities here now. We get to this marine exhibit and find the phone. We get another chopper in the air to lift us out from there.
How are we gonna get there? Troodon could still be out there.
We aren't equipped to treat any more bites. We have to...
Shh!
I will not be shushed.
The door.
Oh no.
They're coming through the vent!
Past the door. Going past the door.
Jerry, get that crate open!
I'm on it. I need somebody to break the lock.
We'll find that something!
I know! Come on, Jerry.
Jerry!
I got it. Let's go.
Junction box. Which lines go toward...
Come on, people, there's...
Way, Laura.
I don't know, Jerry. We must be 40 feet underground. I have no idea where we are.
We can't just sit around with our thumbs up our butts.
I don't hear them anymore. Their behavior seemed territorial. Maybe we're far enough away from the nest that they gave up on us.
We might have outpaced them. We're not exactly in a secure location. Which way are we heading, Doc?
Look over here. Can you read these?
Maybe. If I can find... Yes. Yes. Okay. We're at a four-way intersection. There are only four such intersections on the plan. Let me just cross-reference these detail labels. Okay, we just have to figure out which intersection we're at. Look around the corridors for any distinguishing features. I'll see if I can eliminate possibilities.
Maybe I can help with the plans. They look pretty simple.
I just don't have enough details to make a decision. I don't have enough to go on here. I need details, landmarks, something unique. Look down the corridors. I need to know what you see. Describe it in as much detail as you can.
Big yellow pipe going down the left wall. It crosses over the ceiling partway down the corridor. There's a big yellow pipe going down the left wall. It crosses over the ceiling partway down the corridor. It looks like the corridor ends in a T intersection. There's a ladder on the right, and on the far wall at the end. I see some sort of water tanks at the end of the hall.
What do you think, Jess? This one?
Sure.
There's a ladder on the right, and on the far wall at the end. It looks like the corridor ends in a T intersection. I see some sort of water tanks at the end of the hall.
What do you think, Jess? Probably not this one?
Yeah, I don't think so.
I'm just gonna cross this one off.
Okay, I hope you're right.
There's a big yellow pipe that goes down a bit on the left and then crosses over to the other side. There are these two big electrical boxes of some kind on the right. The tunnel goes straight and then turns to the right. I see two ladders along the left of the tunnel.
What do you think, Jess? Probably not this one?
Yeah, I don't think so.
A set of water tanks partway down the corridor on the right. I see one ladder at the end of the hallway. This tunnel only goes down a few dozen yards to a dead end. There's a set of water tanks partway down the corridor on the right.
Could be here.
I guess they all kind of look the same.
It could be here.
I guess they all kind of look the same.
I don't think it's this one.
How can you keep them all straight?
Okay, everyone, I think I've got it.
Are you sure?
I'm positive. We must be here. It's the only one that completely matches our surroundings. Okay, here we are. The desalination plant is here.
We're not that far.
No, we follow this route here. We follow any water mains at junctions in the direction of convergence. Even still, there's barely any turns. Look, just memorize this route.
Down there. I have to go find her.
What? Back down there? With those monsters? No, Jerry. She needs you safe. Jess is a strong and resourceful girl. She's doing like we are doing. Surviving.
You can't know that. I won't leave her to those animals.
Jerry, look at me. If we go back down there, we won't make it to the bottom of that ladder. The others escaped down the tunnel we were gonna follow. We know where they're going.
The marine exhibit. That's where Laura would take her.
And Yoder is with them.
Oh, God.
If we're going to join them again, that is where we have to go. The quickest way we can.
You're right. We should be able to make better time over land.
Can you get us there?
Sorkin mentioned the desalination plant. That would be near the ocean, right?
Jerry, the whole island is near the ocean.
Oh, right, but we pump seawater in from the lagoon. They must have built the marine exhibit near the waterworks.
Lagoon? I think I know where that is. Let me get my bearings, and we'll figure out how to get there. Por el amor de Dios.
Do you know where we are?
Let me think. It's been so long. This is my first time back on the island in nearly 12 years. Engine has changed it so much.
Nima, this island. There's more to it, isn't there? To you, I mean.
Yes. It is very dear to me.
Tell me.
I grew up here, you know, below those trees. My people were fishermen. We would make our homes near the water during the fishing season. I loved the water. I would swim in the ocean. So far. That's why my father called me Nima. I could go anywhere. Run in the jungle. Climb the trees. These monsters. There was never anything like them on this island before. It was all very peaceful before Injun bought the island from Costa Rica.
I see now.
You and your family used to live on this island?
My family, everyone, my whole tribe. This had been our home for thousands of years. The island is so different now. I know the island. It's part of me. But when Injun came to the island, important men from Costa Rica came and asked my father to go back with them. They wanted my father to make a good impression so that Costa Rica could ask Injun for a good deal of money for our island. When he was in Costa Rica, he was asked to cut his hair and wear a suit so that he wouldn't seem simple to the Injun people. I felt as I feel now. My father was different. I knew him, but some part of him had been lost. My father was an awa, a spiritual healer. He sang for Sibo, who created the earth. He was very important to our tribe. But after we left the island, he would not keep up the old traditions. He was always unhappy.
What is Sibo?
That mountain there. It is like a house, my father said. My people believe that the animals of the world built it. Before Injun, and my father and I would go to the ocean to fish. When I would swim in the ocean, my father would say, Nima! Little fish, do not swim so far. I cannot catch you so far out. When Injun came to move us to Costa Rica, I became very angry with my father. Whatever he would tell me to do, I would refuse. But he would never be angry with me. He would say that I am a fish who would never eat the fisher's bait. He was right. To me, everything had a string attached.
You remind me of Jess. I mean, that's how it used to be with us before the divorce. I'd take her to the museums or to the zoo. She'd always climb up onto things, you know, such a climber. She can't not climb over things, into things. Climbed into a tiger pen once. With a live tiger.
But not anymore?
No, things haven't been the same since the divorce.
He would always remind me of my stubbornness. I think I believe that's how I must always be. You know, no ties, no temptation. But then I had Irlanda, my Mariquita. She is almost of an age where she will outgrow my protection. Young girls on the streets in my neighborhood, they get snatched up by local cartels, run drugs. Or worse, some just disappear.
Jess changed my life, too. She was my second wife, second daughter. Apparently, I'm the genetic carrier of rebellion because both my daughters got it. I worked so hard to protect Jess and keep her out of trouble.
What about you? Did you turn out so good because your parents kept you out of trouble?
Me? I was a little hellion myself. Uncontrollable. It's in my genes. Oh, now you know this is different. Still, one thing Jess really hasn't had in her life is a present father figure.
Now there is no choice. Everything I do for her. Now I am the fisher, and at the same time, I have come to a way in my life where I must always chase the bait. I want for Atlanta to be free. I want for her to have opportunities that I didn't have. I just hope I can be there for her the way my father was there for me. She can be stubborn like her mother used to be and refuse the fisher's bait. I think I know now it's a good way to be. I think that my father believed that too.
Jess changed my life, too. She was my second wife, second daughter. Apparently, I'm the genetic carrier of rebellion because both my daughters got it. I worked so hard to protect Jess and keep her out of trouble.
What about you? Did you turn out so good because your parents kept you out of trouble?
Me? I was a little hellion myself. Uncontrollable. It's in my genes. Oh, now you know this is different. Still, one thing Jess really hasn't had in her life is a present father figure. Nima, look, I...
What is it?
I'm sorry about what Injun has done to your island. This isn't the way things should have been done.
I don't blame you, Jerry. You're a good person. I see that.
But I take my pay from Injun. I owe you something.
All right, Jerry. Enough talk.
You know where we are?
I have a good idea. It's a difficult hike. Do you feel rested?
Hungry. A little thirsty, but I just want to get to Jess.
Good.
chorus?
Hello?
That was actually the call of a whooping swan. Dinosaurs shared many features with modern-day birds. For instance, we now know that many theropod dinosaurs from the Jurassic period's vocal organs are just like modern birds. We are arriving at the fourth of seven lookouts along the tour. Your Jurassic Park tour vehicle will stop for 5 minutes to let you stretch your legs and take photographs of our animals. Next stop, the Jurassic Park Marine Facility and Aquarium.
Would you look at this?
What are they?
They look like feeder tanks. This could be a hatchery.
A hatcher what?
They're raising these fish to feed another animal, like at Marine World.
Like the killer whales?
Precisely.
That's a lot of fish. How many whales are they feeding?
I don't know. It looks like each of these tanks could feed 3 or 4 orcas per day.
Oh, you're a fish expert now.
I can make an educated guess.
Look, there's a sign over there. It looks like a schedule or something.
This is a hatchery. That's the stocking schedule for the tanks.
Something tells me these fish aren't for feeding whales, huh, Doc? Hold up. All clear.
Dad!
Jess! Oh, thank God. Are you okay? Are you hurt?
No, I'm okay. Just, can we go home now?
I'm so glad you two are safe, Jerry. How did you manage to get here?
We climbed out of the tunnels through a service hatch near one of the tour routes. Luckily, someone left the tour program running. Thanks.
You mean...
Dr. Sorkin, the phones are not working.
I'm sorry?
There is no dial tone. You said the phones would be working here.
That's odd. My control terminal showed that the main lines here were active. Unless... Of course. Everything is controlled by the computer systems, even the phones. If the power outage outlasted the battery backups, then the system is probably just waiting to be booted up.
Get us to the phones, Doc. We don't have a lot of time.
Mr. Yoder, I refuse to be pushed around by you any longer.
Look, this isn't a day trip. If we don't contact InGen and get another helicopter out here for you all, the next flight over the island is gonna be a wing of B-52s carrying holy hellfire.
What?
That's right, Doc. We're gonna murder all your precious little pets and sink this island into the Pacific.
Dios mío. That's what you meant by Ground Zero?
Yeah, that's right.
Why didn't you tell me earlier? This is my home!
What do you mean, your home? I didn't tell you earlier because I thought we'd be off the island by now.
This island is the ancestral home of her people.
Wait, what is Dr. Sorkin doing?
Laura? Wait, what are you...
Where is she going?
I don't know. This rotunda, it's where the control room is. She's going to the phones without us.
Damn it, get that elevator back up here!
Oh, they've really made a lot of progress in construction here. Paleozoic, huh? Well, most of the specimens here aren't really from the Jurassic period anyway. Ah, Paleozoic. From oldest to newest. Cambrian, Ordovician, Silurian, Devonian, Carboniferous, Permian. Interesting concept. Living fossils. I guess you can't expect a mosquito to feed on fish swimming hundreds of meters under the sea.
This little pool's cool. Were these creatures all cloned like the dinosaurs?
No, these aren't actually extinct animals, Jess. They live in the oceans today. They're called living fossils because they haven't evolved much from the ancient fossil forms discovered by paleontologists.
Oh, is that a horseshoe crab?
Could be. To be honest, I don't really know all that much about sea fauna.
Fauna.
How you holding up, Jess?
I can't stop shaking. I'd literally rather be back in jail for shoplifting. I'm just so tired of running, Dad.
I know, me too. But we're safe for now.
How did you two get here so fast?
A tour vehicle picked us up.
Great. Here I was running for my life in those tunnels, and you two are on a date.
A date? Give me a break.
Dad, I'm so sorry I caused all this trouble.
Hey, this isn't your fault.
It is! With the smoking, the dinosaurs, the stealing, my grades, I don't mean to be such a screw-up all the time.
Look, Jess, I know I can come down on your heart sometimes. I feel like I have to cram months of being a dad into the few short days I get with you. But you're an amazing young woman. I'm proud of you, and I don't want you to have to make the same mistakes I've made.
I don't want to do this anymore, Dad. Can't we just wait here for another rescue?
That's what we're gonna do. But first, we have to call for that other rescue.
What if it goes just as bad as the first one?
Hey, look at me. We'll get through this. What do I always say about the glass of water being half full or half empty, huh?
Hey, I ordered a beer.
That's my girl. I'll be over by the info desk, okay?
Yeah, Dad.
Information. Sure could use some now. Huh. Very clever. Looks like they're using numbers from the dates of the Paleozoic era as daily key codes. Okay. So the plaque for the Paleozoic era preceded the oldest period at the display. Maybe the sequence doesn't start at the beginning of the week. Today is Saturday. I need Friday's code. Silurian. Good a guess as any. I'm not too sure. There's enough here for me to deduce the order, if I can just recall the order of the display. Permian sounds right. Okay, best guess. Oh, good. Instructions. Insert operator's key into key slot. Okay, etc., etc. Code expires in 24 hours. Morning operations reset procedure. Turn key counterclockwise to input notch and hold for 3 seconds. Keypad will reset and beep 3 times. Turn key clockwise to reset. Enter previous code, then new code. Huh, that's easy enough. Silurian. Okay, let's try it at the elevator. Turn key to input, hold for 3 seconds, turn to reset, then enter old code, followed by a new code. Input, hold, reset, code. This is my best guess. I'll try it at the elevator. Turn key to input, hold for 3 seconds, turn to reset, then enter old code, followed by a new code. Input, hold, reset, code. This is my best guess. I'll try it at the elevator. Turn key to input, hold for 3 seconds, turn to reset, then enter old code, followed by a new code. Input, hold, reset, code. Thank you. Permian. Okay, best guess. Turn key to input, hold for 3 seconds, turn to reset, then enter old code, followed by a new code. Input, hold, reset, code. Is everything all right between you two?
Mind your own business and get the elevator running.
I wasn't talking to you.
No more fighting. Things are bad enough as they are.
Nine, two, five, one. All right! New code. Let's keep it simple.
Hey, don't open that. Are you crazy? Someone will see.
Relax.
See what?
Damn it, you careless idiot.
What was that thing? Some kind of spy gear?
Yeah, that's right. Top secret. In fact, if you tell anyone about it, I'll have to kill you.
You won't lay a finger on her.
I was just kidding around.
Everyone, I got the elevator working.
About time.
What's going on here?
Nothing. We're all cool.
It. Let's go. We don't got all day.
Dad, my ears.
Attention.
What's going on?
The Lagoon Rotunda and Spectacular is housed in a pressurized underwater environment. We suggest you pinch your nose and push your breath to equalize your ears while we descend. If you experience any lasting discomfort or feel unusually giddy, let your attendant know immediately.
Giddy?
They're talking about nitrogen narcosis. It's a risk of breathing pressurized air.
What makes you the expert?
I saw it in a movie.
Whoa! Is that where we're going?
I think so. This
is so cool.
Careful, I'll lead.
Cool. Look at that.
I want to speak with Hammond. No, this can't wait. Can you connect me to Mr. McGuire? Or no, Peter Ludlow. Please hurry. No, look. This is Dr. Laura
Sorrell. Oh, I have a bad feeling about this.
I am still on the premises. Get me somebody. Mr. Parker, I do not need rescuing. I do not want the bombing waylaid. I want it stopped. not contaminated. This is a wildlife preserve. These animals are not diseased. They are extremely endangered.
It's locked from the inside.
You're not listening to me!
Hey, Dad! This looks like an intercom up here.
What? Where?
Good find, honey.
Laura, it's me, Jerry. Laura?
Jerry, I hear you, and I'm glad you're here. This is gonna be a lot easier now.
What have you been doing?
We're gonna stop the bombing, Jerry. This island must be preserved. I have taken the remaining survivors hostage. There are four others, three Americans and one Costa Rican. I won't let them go unless the plans to bomb the island are completely rescinded.
You have no right to hold us like this!
Rights are just an ideological construct.
Don't turn this into a philosophy debate!
What rights do the dinosaurs have? Don't they have the right to survive? Do their rights outweigh any of ours?
It is not our rights versus theirs. Our dinosaurs are phantoms. Majestic as they may be, alive as they may be, we brought them into a world that is no longer prepared for them. We have a responsibility to keep them isolated and under rein for the safety of our ecosystem. It's not rights, it's responsibility!
And we have a responsibility to preserve our creations and allow them a chance to survive on their own terms.
Billy, will InGen stop the bombing?
Doubt it. InGen is not the one dropping bombs, it's the U.S. military. And the contingency is based around a biohazard cover story. She may just be delaying the inevitable.
If you don't offer me some sort of guarantee that the island will be preserved, I will have to escalate matters.
This is lunacy! Fine, put the military on the phone. Hello? Hello? You want to see contamination of the global ecosystem?
Laura, there are other options here. Holding us against our will to save the dinosaurs is only one poorly thought-out solution. You're smarter than that, Laura.
I know, Jerry. I know what I'm doing. I clearly expressed the consequences of threatening this island. I scored a line in the sand that has been ignored and trampled over by InGen, by the government, and now I exercise my resolve.
Laura?
I'm going to free the Mosasaur.
Are you mad? A land dinosaur paddling to the mainland is one thing, but you're talking about releasing an apex predator into over 70% of the global ecosystem.
It's only one. It can be recaptured.
Before it eats the last of the humpbacks?
Oh, don't be dramatic.
Laura, don't.
Plan B.
Sorry, Jerry. For the sake of this island and the scientific treasure it holds, I have been forced to take an action.
It's not too late. We can reverse this.
No. I locked the system down. There's nothing you can do. I've opened the gates and the Mosasaur is free to leave.
Laura, you have to...
No, Jerry, this isn't up for debate. We have to show InGen...
Look out! Get out of the water! Damn it! What were you thinking?
All right, everybody, be cool. And stay away from the window.
Be cool?
That's right. What? You want an I told you so? I don't know about you, but I came here to make a phone call. Hello, this is William Yoder, ID 4122. Put me through to Haskell. Yes, sir. Yes, sir, the U.S. Embassy. Report as follows. The island is completely overrun. Alpha team killed in action, save one, myself. Bravo team killed in action. Two helicopters disabled. Two civilian casualties. I have access to a seaworthy boat and I will evacuate the remaining survivors. Yes, sir. The military may proceed. 90 minutes. Understood, sir.
What's happening? Who did you call?
That's far enough.
What?
You're not coming with me. There's going to be a tragic accident, Jerry. Nima, we have everything we need. We're finishing this without them.
What?
No.
What do you mean, no? We've got an agreement, remember?
An agreement doesn't involve killing Jerry and Jess.
What's going on?
I'm sorry, Jerry. I was sent here to retrieve dinosaur embryos from InGen.
I don't understand. You're a corporate spy?
Yes.
Damn it, Nima! I trusted you!
It's not like that. Yoder took the can. He wants it for himself. Trying to help you and Jess.
What can?
A can of shaving cream. It has a compartment to smuggle the embryos off the island.
Damn it, Nima. You're blowing it.
No, you are. Oscar put his faith in you. He may have been a devil, but he wore his sins on his arm for everyone to see. You are just a mask with nothing behind it.
No, you can't do this! Don't you care? Don't you care about Oscar or Decap?
That's enough. Everyone stay back. I'm gonna give you a sporting chance here.
Billy,
once
wait.
I let go of the spoon, there ain't no coming back.
Don't do this!
Run!
Thank you.
Is anybody hurt? Is everyone all right?
You mean, besides being trapped in this bubble by that desgraciado, we're as good as dead?
Don't say that. Somebody might, somebody will come for us.
Oh, Jerry. Yoder left us here. He'll take the boat and not tell anyone about us.
Maybe he won't take the boat.
He has the canister. He knows where the boat is.
He, doesn't have the canister.
What?
I'm sorry. I promise not to steal anymore.
Okay,
but
that one's a freebie.
Jerry, look!
Oh, great. Just great.
Why is it flooding?
Must be the damage to the door. We're losing air pressure. This place will flood right up to the highest hole in the room. Damn it! Even if we could open the door against the pressure, the whole rotunda is flooded. There's nowhere to go.
Wait a second. I remember. Maybe there still is a way out. If we swim.
Swim? We won't make it 20 feet with that Mosasaur swimming around.
Maybe. Look at that pipeline. It leads out of this lagoon. There are caves at the far end. Those caves connect to others that lead back to the beaches. We use the pipeline as cover.
And you think we can hold our breath the whole way?
Dad, look! There's diving gear!
No. We don't know the first thing about scuba diving.
I do.
What?
We have to distract the Mosasaur. Figure something out and meet us back down here.
Scuba diving? Oh, come on! How could this be so complicated? I don't know thing one about diving.
Dad, don't mess with the mixture valve. They're all preset.
Since when do you know about diving?
Remember those lessons you wouldn't let me take?
Did your mother override my decision?
Actually, Steve bought me lessons. It was a secret.
Mom's boyfriend?
Yeah. If it's any consolation, I got grounded and Steve slept on the couch for a week.
I'll be right back. Feeder program. Hatchery B, pool 4. That looks like the one scheduled for today's feeding. That ought to keep it busy. Okay, hon. What do we do?
Dad, I changed my mind. These are rebreathers and I've never actually used one. I'm not ready for this.
Hey, you can do this.
No! What if something goes wrong? I don't want to do this. I don't want anyone else to get hurt.
Sweetheart, look at me. You were right about me. I don't give you the trust you deserve. I don't give you a chance to prove it either. But here, now, you've done more than enough to earn that trust. I know you're capable of great things. I trust you, Jess. I know this is something you can do.
I just don't want you to go away. I'm so tired of you always going away.
I know, honey, but I'm here right now, and I'm not gonna leave you alone. I'll be here with you all the way. Now, what's the diver signal for okay?
It's universal, duh.
Right. Well, I promise to signal you whenever you check on me, okay?
I'm scared.
I am too. But I know we'll make it with your help. Okay, Jess, you ready?
Yeah, let's do this.
So, how do these things work?
Well, these are closed-circuit rebreathers. They look custom-designed. The tank is small, maybe 15 minutes of air.
Is that enough?
But it recycles the air you exhale. It should work for about 45 minutes. Try not to freak out. You use air faster. You might even mess up the CO2 scrubbers.
That sounds bad.
CO2 poisoning is totally bad. This is the regulator. It's built into the mask. It wants to help you breathe. Don't fight it. And don't hold your breath.
Okay, don't hold my breath.
That's it. The suit's mostly automated. It'll keep you, like, buoyant and manage your oxygen. Oh, and try to swim casual.
Swim casual?
Don't spaz out. It attracts sharks.
What about mosasaurs?
Probably them too. Turn around.
Thank you.
Look, by the lighthouse.
Yes, that must be it.
Wait, I don't see anyone on it.
Maybe a dinosaur ate them. Maybe Billy ate them.
Well, well, well. Fortune smiles upon the brave.
Hey, Dad!
I thought I'd worked everything out. Hadn't accounted for our little thief here. Well played, Jess. Well played.
But then, I was sure I had buried my ticket off this island at the bottom of the sea.
But, lo and behold, you slippery sons of bitches survived. Wait. Did you swim out of there?
You bastard. What will your bosses think when they learn that you tried to murder us?
But they won't learn about that. Because one way or another, you're not gonna tell them. I just don't know how we got to this point, Nima. You were the last one of my kind I thought I could trust. Things didn't start out that way, but we had worked out a mutually beneficial deal! But now, I don't even have that. All that's left for me is that damn canister. Now hand it over, Missy. Ah! Nice one. Almost hurt.
You looking for this?
You know, things don't have to be this way. We'll kiss and make up, and share this payout, just like we planned.
I am sorry I did not see your true self long ago. I could have saved us all a lot of trouble and kicked your ass to begin with.
Oh, come on, don't make this easy for me. Come on, Nima. You're a merc, just like me. You got bills to pay? Are these two really worth all this?
I am not like you. You are a monster, worse than the things on this island. No more talk. Shut up and fight.
What's that? I can have it? Why so generous all of a sudden?
You wanna be the hero?
Just...
You wanna break our deal?
Do you feel that?
Oh my god. Stop!
You wanna make new friends?
Yoder!
And Nima, I don't like it.
Thank you.
We made it. Believe me, the whole world is better off without that can.
Guys?
Not me, Joey. Not my daughter.
Guys?
Nemo, I made a promise. I'll figure something out. Come back to Dallas with us. We'll find a way to get you and your Mariquita.
Guys! How much did you say those embryos were worth?